McClure and Thomas Turgoose. Hello.
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 You must be like, everywhere you go, people must be high-fiving you. You must be having the greatest time at the moment.
Yeah, we are actually. I've just been texting Johnny Harris, who played Mick, played my dad in it. And we're just like, God, isn't it great? Just having moments of just being so happy that we've done it and everyone's just buzzing about it. So just going to keep it while it's here.
Are you getting loads of free stuff from meeting cool people?
We're getting quite a few free, like, I know that Jimmy Carr invited us all to his show, and Paloma Faith, who's lovely, she invited us to her show as well.
And so, Darren Brown as well.
Brilliant. So we've got Darren Brown.
Is there anything that you want that you haven't been offered yet? Because, I mean, you're on the radio, you can ask for it.
Oh, yeah.
New shoes.
I was going to say a house.
Lots of shoes.
If, like, Best or Eves want to send out.
Yeah, free shoes and a guitar for my dad, because he's just moaning about guitars.
What did Annabelle, when you got a new flat once, we asked for free stuff, what did you get?
I got a Brita water filter.
Oh, lovely. Great, well, they are good.
Yeah.
Yeah, so Brita water filter.
Well, no, if we're going to, I can't really go with that one. I think, like, an iPhone 4 or a, you know,
an
a Mac. Or, yeah, an iPad.
Yeah. Yeah. I'll shout out for an iPad, give me
I'll
a free
double
iPad.
Double shout iPad.
You said it first.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
No, you said it first. How does the reaction you're getting now compared to when the film first came out?
A lot of people are recognising me a lot more because I've grown up a lot more and you know, and well, I hope I'll change a little bit, but I haven't changed much since the series.
No, you haven't.
From when I did the film, because it took so long to come out, I changed a lot. So you know, it was kind of, I wasn't really getting recognised as much and what have you, but for the series and stuff, I've been getting recognised quite a lot more.
And how was it for you? Have you left school now, Shaun?
Yeah, I left school like 2 years ago.
Oh, did you really?
Yeah.
How old are you now then?
Nearly 19.
Right, so you left at 16.
Yeah.
And were people dickish at school, or was it all right? Did people take it well?
No, everyone was like, just kind of ignored it, and no one really bothered me, and you know, I was able to get on with my work, and well, I should have been getting on my work. but yeah, it was all right at school. Everyone was kind of just.
What were your results like? Should we not go into it?
No, there was quite bad.
Right.
But I never failed any of past them all.
Yeah, well, you're busy with other things. So, the programme and the film, I mean, it's tough issues that it's dealing with, but also from watching, you get the impression that it's a right laugh to do. Is it a laugh?
Yeah, it is a really, really good laugh. You know, with all the gang and stuff, like
yeah,
all
yeah,
the gang
yeah.
together, like, we always have a really good laugh.
Yeah.
I love it.
Who's the most fun?
It's got to be Woody.
Yeah, definitely Joe.
That's what you'd guess.
Or Mike Soccer.
Yeah, yeah.
The guy who plays Harvey.
It's kind of when you get them two together.
When you get them two together, it's like
a real double act.
All over again.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
And what is it like, practical jokes, messing about?
Oh, yeah,
impressions,
all that.
Yeah. Everything.
Yeah. Everything. Yeah, just taking a mick out of each other all the time and stuff.
And one thing I love about the film is you talk like real people. I'm not talking about the accents necessarily, but the words you're using and the phrasing, it doesn't sound like it's been written. How does Shane Meadows do that?
Well, Shane's block, he did episodes 3 and 4, and he got us to improvise the majority of it. So there was a script, and it was a great script written by Jack Thorne as well. And it jumped off the page, but when you get in there with Shane, it's just kind of, just go for it. So just rolls off the tongue.
So it's kind of a question of, this is what's going to happen in this scene.
Yeah,
and,
there's your plot, try and get this storyline through, and then just, you know your character.
So when you're improvising, did you have to think about words and phrases that weren't used in the 80s?
Yeah, a little bit. You can't say things like, oh, that's sick. Or, you know, you did have to be a little bit,
I noticed on Twitter there was a debate raging because you'd said whatever. Now, I think I remember saying whatever to my parents in the 80s, but some people were saying you would never say whatever in the 80s.
Oh, I don't know.
I don't know, I wasn't alive. I wasn't even planning.
I wasn't
an accident,
alive.
Are you enjoying Twitter, Vicky?
No, I really wasn't.
No, I know, we don't need to get into that.
Are you enjoying Twitter?
I'm not. I've still got to get the hang of it. I think this, like, I only just figured out what FF means.
Follow Friday.
Yeah, just got that. And I need to probably just. I've been off it for a couple of days, but I have been like busy. I should really tweet.
Somebody just texted in. Why did Geoff just call Thomas Shaun? Did I just do that?
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Do you get that all the time?
Yeah, no, not
other interviewers are professional enough to remember that you're not actually the same character that you play on the
some
television.
Some people do, because a lot of people don't know my real name, but.
Well, I know it. I just keep forgetting. And when you're making it, how much of an, like, so you're doing your bits? How much of an idea of the whole thing do you have? So how it is, like, either the series or back when you did the film, did you know how it would all hang together?
The film, I don't think was... The film was slightly different. Like, that was a creative process whilst we were shooting it. You know, there was a definite plot.
Yeah.
But with the series, because of the time that we had and it was all quite regimented with it being TV, we was really clear on what was happening, so...
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It was a bit stricter than the film.
So there are no bits that when you watch it for the first time at a screening or on the telly or whatever, you've never seen them and you've got no idea about them?
What, when we watched them?
Yeah, yeah.
I knew what was coming, but I don't know, you know when you watch it, you kind of forget.
Yeah.
There were certain scenes where I was like, oh, God, yeah, I forgot about that.
Yeah.
Like, you wouldn't have seen the sex scenes?
No, well, I heard it because I was outside, but I never saw a lot of them.
What do you mean?
No, when Gadge and Trudy was doing
the
sex scenes, I was outside because I was in my flat board.
I remember watching your sex scene with Smell in the toilet.
Yeah, everyone was there for that scene.
Yeah, I know, but it was all around the monitors like that.
No one was allowed on set for everyone else's, but then when it comes to mine and Roz's, it was like...
Get around the monitors, come on, squeeze
everyone in. Everyone was there, and it's just like, that's a bit unfair. It's like my first sex scene.
Right, I'm going to play a record, and then we'll talk some more to Lol McClure and Shaun Thurgoose in a few minutes. Vicky, you mentioned Johnny Morris, not the...
Johnny Harris.
Is it Johnny Harris?
Yeah.
I was going to say, that's the animal guy, isn't it? Johnny Harris, who played your dad in the programme before, and you've been doing some of these interviews with him. How can you sit in the same room with that man?
Easily. He's a legend. Honestly, he's nowhere near his character, obviously. He's just the nicest guy. He's just so talented, you know?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, he's brilliant in the programme, but and I don't want to go too much into it, because people might not have seen it, and they might be waiting for the DVD or whatever. But... just some harrowing scenes. How is it, like, 5 seconds after you've done that and they've gone, oh, okay.
It's not 5 seconds after, nothing's really changed. I'm still, like, lying on the floor, like, trying to breathe and not cry. So, it takes a bit of time to get out of it.
But you must have to summon up this hatred for him.
Yeah, I do. It was easy because he looks, when I look at the character, Johnny looks very different now. He hasn't got a great big beard and, he's not wearing them hideous clothes. So it's very different. But when we're on set, you can feel the tension and it is there. And, me and Johnny just work well together. I think that was the key to it, really.
So when you do a difficult scene, is it a bit like when you have a bad dream? Does it stay with you for the rest of the day and stuff? How do you get in a good mood after doing a scene? Which is hard work, emotionally.
Do you know what? Having these lot around, people like Shane, who's just, complete genius at what he does and just so funny. Yeah. And then just having the gang going back to the flats at night and everyone just coming around and going, are you all right? How was that? Harrowing. Make me a cup of tea. Just having the guys around helped massively.
You mentioned just off the air that you live in Nottingham.
Yeah.
Is it true that there are 95 girls to every boy in Nottingham?
That is... It has been said, but I wouldn't know if that's
true.
That's
where you should move to.
Yeah, I'm not moving to London now. I'm going to move to Nottingham.
Don't move to Nottingham, Tomo. We don't want you. Stay in Grimsby.
Is that the thing everyone always says about Nottingham?
I've heard
Nottingham?
That, but,
It is. I've heard there's 250 girls to every
boy. It keeps going up. I was going to say, I've heard it, but that was quite high, that fact.
I think it was a ruse invented by Nottingham University to get more...
Probably what it is.
Yeah, more people going there.
Maybe.
Hey, Thomas, you mentioned your first sex scene earlier, and you did your first snogging scene, I guess, with Smell in the original film. How old were you?
In the film, I was 14.
So would that be your first proper snog?
No. No, it wasn't.
You were an early starter.
Yeah, I was. I can't remember how old was it. I think it was about 11 or 12 or something.
Who was it?
It was a girl called Danielle.
Oh.
Yeah.
Where was it?
It was in my front garden when I lived on quite a rough estate when I was younger.
Yeah.
And it was in my front garden and I can remember being like really nervous about it. And as soon as I'd done it, I ran away. I did. I kissed her and ran away.
Yeah. Did you ever see her again?
Yeah, because she lived like across the road. Like, and I used to
was
see her.
Was she shouting after you come back?
No, because I think she was quite professional at it. Like, she'd
professional. She, you say money changed hands?
No.
Was she from Nottingham?
No, I think she kissed a lot of lads before. So,
right.
So yeah, but I was quite embarrassed, and I was laying in bed thinking, did I do that properly? Was that right? And then, yeah.
But you're good at it now.
I don't know.
And how was
come here, we'll try.
And what's the girl who plays Michelle called in the film?
Roz. Rosamund Hanson.
How is she at kissing?
Different.
In what way? Toothsome? What?
Like in the series, whether she kisses like this, she better not be listening. No. In the series, well, obviously, smell might kiss different to Roz.
Yeah.
But, you know, smells just kind of eats your face kind of thing, which is kind of, you know, different.
Does Shaun kiss differently to you?
No.
No?
No, I don't think so.
How about you? Does Lowell kiss differently to you, Vicky?
Yeah, I think she does.
In what way?
I don't know. I don't like the question. I don't know what to say.
I'm too
busy laughing at Tom.
Do you ever practice these things before you do them, before they roll the cameras?
What, like on the back of your hand or something?
Yeah, on a pillow. No, I mean, because it must be really awkward kissing someone you work with for the first time.
Do you know what? It's not. We're all such good mates. It's not really weird. It's like we was all sat watching Tomo's sex scene with Roz, and it was just funny. And I think it kind of... I think to some degree it might have relaxed you more. No?
No, not at all.
Knowing that you've got an audience.
Not even a little bit. Okay. I felt like that I had to step up a bit because everyone was watching this.
And what's happening with you two next? Have you got anything on?
Do you know what? We was only saying to each other today, none of us, between me and Tomo, everyone else is going off and doing their great jobs. Yeah. And me and Tomo have just sat pretty waiting.
That's probably why you're in here.
Well, that's it. We're doing all the press for everybody while they're working. No, we can't possibly do press. We're busy. Me and Tomo were like, yeah, we'll be down there in a bit.
So, I mean, we were talking about it. Me and Vicky are going to go sign on.
Yeah, we're going to go and
doll,
yeah,
get some free money.
Yeah, yeah, do that. Well, yeah. While you still can before they start cutting it.
It's already happened, isn't it?
And I'm sure you've been asked this everywhere you go. Can you see there being revisiting these characters in another 3 years and so on?
Yeah, there's definitely talk of it, and, you know, fingers crossed, because we're all up for it. But we'll just wait and see.
Great.
See what happens.
Well, if you... I'm talking to listeners now, not to you. I know you will have seen it. But if you haven't seen it, the DVD is out today, and now I'm talking to you again. Vicky and Thomas, thank you so much for coming and talking to us.
Thank you. Cheers.